You've got an exciting group here. They can't wait to meet you.
What's happening?
I don't think we did this last time we were here.
No.
When were you here last time?
Oh my gosh, when was I here? Probably a year ago.
At least, yeah.
A year or more ago.
Okay, so you guys, this is Odette. Say hello.
Hello.
Hello. So Lisa's going to be on soon, so we're going to lower the volume in a second, but let's go one by one. You guys can introduce yourselves.
Hi, I'm Cliff Roth, and I'm from New Jersey.
Okay. Hi, Odette. I'm Kempton Lem. I'm from Calgary, Canada.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Odette. I'm nice Kim Beasley, and I'm in Kansas City, Missouri.
Awesome.
Michael, your turn.
I'm Michael Banks, and I'm from Augusta, Georgia.
Nice.
Awesome.
So, Kempton's been drooling. I'm going to just call him out.
You call me out right away? No.
Yes, you have, Kempton.
Yeah,
I know you are. I know you are so pretty because of House, and you did such a great role in House, and I love you. But my friend, Alina Chen, she's in Hong Kong, and she told me, like, it was a few days ago, she said, oh, drop dead gorgeous. And then I have to look up an online compilation of your sexy scenes, and those are really hard.
Like we said, he's been drooling.
Yeah, hilarious. You made my morning.
Yeah.
He used to be shy, but he's really kind of blossomed.
Wow, I can tell.
So I want to ask you, in House, what was that experience working with the cast and especially the star of the show? That must be awesome. And I have no idea you actually toned it down so much. Like, you were pretty in the show, but you are gorgeous in person.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, well, you know, the whole doctor thing, they didn't want to overdo the makeup and, you know, and all that. But it was a really, really great experience. I really loved it. Hugh Laurie is just, I bow down to him. He's such a great actor, such a great person. But the whole cast, they were so warm and welcoming, and I came on to do the last season, and it was, you know, I had to learn a lot of words. I felt like I came out, you know, going through medical school, but it was, you know, it was a great experience. It
was
really fun.
Yeah, that must
be
hard to, like, not only do you need to just know your lines and script, but you have to, like, know, like, legit
terms. You know, sometimes you can go on to, a set and sort of, you know, you don't have to know every single line. You can, you know, with this, it was, you couldn't change a comma or a but. You had to know every single, you know, everything that you were saying and actually know the definitions, because if not,
you actually needed to know what you were talking about.
Exactly.
That can be challenging, right?
So I have a question for you.
Yes, go for it.
Golden Boy. I love that show. I just started watching it. You know, it just came in as a half-season replacement. What was your experience on that show, and will your character be recurring?
My character, I think I've already finished the run on Golden Boy. So I moved to New York with my husband. He was doing a TV show called 666 Park Avenue. Just got canceled, unfortunately.
Wait, just totally broke.
Oh, I remember. I've seen that show.
And she's married. Sorry.
Yeah, I know.
I read the bio.
Yeah,
unfortunately for me.
So I was looking to do something in New York. I wanted to shoot in New York, and I wanted to keep myself busy. And Golden Boy, it just, you know, the opportunity just came up, and I did a couple episodes, and it was really fun. I was playing a DA. I mean, I went from doctor to DA to now surfer. I mean,
that's awesome.
Yeah,
though.
It's really great.
Yeah. I think, Michael, you had a question, right?
I do. Beverly Oshawa. It's like, what was the difference from being in the camera to do, like, a voiceover?
It's awesome. You don't have to wear makeup. You can go in and wear your PJs, and it's the best kind of work ever. And you know what? Beverly Hills are always kind of like a machine now. Now we just shot a pilot, so hopefully if it gets picked up, there will be an animated TV show, Beverly Hills Chihuahua, on Disney. So,
but also, since you're just doing your voice, you feel like you have to be, like, extra animated, right?
You do. You have to be extra animated and really, you know, excited and on point, and, you know, your voice can't sound like you smoked 100 cigarettes and drank, you know, Jack Daniels all night, so you have to sort of, you know, drink some hot tea and make your voice sound very clear. But other than that, it's the easiest job on the planet and the most fun. I really love doing it. Yeah.
So you have, like, an interesting background, too. I mean, your dad's Cuban. Oh, no, your mom's Cuban,
mom's
and your
Cuban.
Dad is Italian and French.
Mm-hmm,
Do
mm-hmm.
you speak any other languages, or have you?
No, I don't. I always vowed to learn French, but it's
not yet.
Still hasn't happened. I'm working on it. But my father was born in Colombia, so he speaks perfect Spanish as well. So it's hard to get out of the, you know, the whole Latin
And okay, so you're only 27, but you were going to Loyola Marymount for business. So how did that come up?
I never actually went. I was about to go, and then I thought, well, I don't want to half-ass anything. My passion is acting, and I want to go full force.
Right.
If that doesn't pan out, which, you know, it's really difficult to make it in this town, I would have gone to school. So,
you guys, I'm lowering the volume just a little, just because Lisa's on, but we can still talk.
So, in the new girl, are you going to be a regular, serious regular? And how are you going to go toe to toe to Zooey Deschanel, like
intimidated. she's really, really cool. The whole cast is great. I mean, I walked on and I met all the guys first, and they're just jokes the whole time. Everything that they do is just, you know, I have to be quiet. But no, I'm not going to be a series regular, but the characters, they've left it open so I can come in and out as Nick's boss.
Oh, I see. Nice. Wow, that's cool.
I was about to introduce whoever just left. Okay. So thus far, what's been your favorite role? Or can you even, it's hard, huh?
It's so hard. I've had such a great time on everything I've done, but there was a show, October Road, that I did for ABC. Mm-hmm. And I just had the best time doing
it. What's that one about?
It was about a guy that moved back home after 10 years, and he has a son, and it was just like sort of, if you watch the movie Beautiful Girls, the show was based on that movie.
Okay, gotcha.
So I played Natalie Portman's older self in the show. It was just fun because, you know, when you're on set sometimes and you're shooting on location, we shot that in Georgia, in Atlanta, and it was like summer camp, you know?
Yeah.
You stay in the same hotel, you're going out for drinks and dinners and breakfasts, and you're always all together. So I think we just created a really nice bond. And House was also really on top of my list.
Mm-hmm. Well, you obviously have like a bright future ahead, and you have like so much to do because you're only 27.
Two more questions.
No, Campton. I want one too.
You go first. You go first. I'll go first. You can answer.
Okay, my quick question. In looking at the future, what type of role do you want to work on next, and what would be your ideal role?
Well, I'm actually working on a pilot right now, so I'm shooting a pilot for ABC called West Side. So. Mm-hmm. You know, knock on wood, if hopefully that goes, but it's a really cool role. She's an entrepreneur, she's a surfer, she's basically, it's a modern day telling of Romeo and Juliet, so I would be playing the Juliet character, and that's my middle name. So I start work on that this week, and Mick G is directing, so that should be a really great time. But you know, as far as my dream role, I'm just looking, you know, for any scripts or, you know, TV show or movies, it's all based on the script and on the story and on the character. You know, that's all really, and something that I really connect to, because there could be, you know, an amazing movie, but if I don't connect to the character, then I'm not doing anybody any justice by taking on the
role. Plus, you don't want it to feel like work. Like, you actually enjoy what you're doing. So it's a blessing.
Yeah, you have to believe what you're doing.
Okay, Kempton, go for it quickly.
Right. So your husband Dave is so lucky to have you. So tell us, when he was dating you, and then when was moment that you realized, okay, this is the guy I want to marry for life? What did he do? What did he do?
Why are you torturing yourself? You know, the thing about Dave is that he's really a romantic at heart, and he's such a gentleman. And when I met him, I wasn't looking for a boyfriend. I wasn't looking for anything.
How long have you been married?
We've been married for 2.5 years. But he really just pulled out all the stops. He would bring me flowers, and, you know, he would just do really small little, he would leave me notes on my car, and he was just really, really thoughtful, and I had never had that before. I always dated guys that were not the best guys. So he really just swept me off my feet, and we're best friends, so we just have a great time together. We just so hang
is
out.
Is he in the industry as well? Or
he is. Okay. He's an actor.
So does that help, you think, the relationship?
I didn't want to date an actor. Because I think a lot of times they can be very selfish, and the list can go on and on and on. But he's great. We're, you know, for us, it's family first. And luckily, he feels the same way. So we're very much, like, our careers come second, and, you know, our relationship and our families, that always comes first.
And one question coming from Maria, who... I don't know if you met her yet or not, but she wants to know how you get your hair to look like this.
Right. The hair question.
Oh, nice. Well, I'm actually using this new, it's called Clear Scalp and Hair Beauty Therapy, and it's such good stuff. And you can get it at the drugstores.
But, like, did someone curl your hair?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I got my hair curled.
Like, with a curling
iron? Yeah, so you just wrap it around the barrel.
Cool. Oh, it's like a barrel curl thingy. Okay. Yeah, she was trying to figure it out. All right.
I'll teach you.
Do we take a picture?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, let's do it. Do you want to come
How
in?
How do I do that?
Yeah, the camera. Yeah, get three pretty girls.
Kempton, you're killing me.
Yeah.
And you you know, he has a girlfriend, but he's still. He has a girlfriend.
Girlfriend?
Yes.
Kempton.
Okay.
Hey, I do this right in front of my girlfriend, too.
Oh, you are so bad, Captain.